So we're going to carry on in this video, Joe, a series of videos that we've done on conduit, whether we've done simple threading of conduit, yep. crank sets, bubble sets, double sets, and also you went on and did.
We looked at bending methods, and we looked specifically at the back of bend to back of bend method that might come in quite helpful for things like AM2.
Oh, or AM2S as it evolves itself out. Yeah, we believe there's a piece of conduit in there that will need a couple of bends in
Absolutely.
It. So, of course, those videos that me and Joe have done on the channel should help you with that. And this video would say, is perhaps one of my students quoted it as a life hack, a phrase that you love, Joe.
I don't like that expression. You see it all over the internet, don't you? It's like, try hanging your clothes up in a wardrobe. Life hack. And it's not a hack, that's just what you do, isn't it? Yeah. But, okay. But these, actually, I genuinely think some of the tips that are coming up today are absolutely brilliant and will help you.
And it's one of those things, when you're training people, you don't realise the little things you do on side to make life easy for yourself. You don't often pass those on, do you? Yeah. And I was just doing something in a lesson, and one of the students shouted out, well, that's almost a life hack for conduit. So that's there. But I know what the other thing you're thinking is, well, come on, get on with the life hack. You're also thinking, one of us is wearing some new merch. Okay, so what's happening there, Joe?
Yeah, finally got myself some Joe Robinson training t-shirts. Yeah, I haven't quite decided to sell it yet. I don't think there's a massive market for that. But what's quite nice as well is when I turn my back to the camera to work on the whiteboard, look at that, Joe Robinson training across the back. Happy days.
So we'd like to think that GSH Electrical, our joint channel, which is installation theory, predominantly testing fault finding with Marcus and on-site with Matt.
Yep.
He's helping you through your apprenticeship, and we'd like to think you're also following Joe's science and principles channel, Joe Robinson training, in order to get through that element as well. There is a third channel, Joe, that can help you as well.
Absolutely. So we'd recommend that you go and follow our other channel, eFIXX, because what you're going to find there is that as GSH Electrical and Joe Robinson training hopefully helps you through the preliminary part of your electrical education and helps you to pass your exams and learn about being an electrician. As you move into the electrical industry and become more deeply involved in that, you're going to realise that things are changing and developing all the time.
Yeah.
And our YouTube channel eFIXX and our website eFIXX.co.uk is where you'll find information about the changes that are happening, where the industry seems to be heading, and keep yourself up to date with some important changes that take place.
Okay, so yeah, we're trying to cover all the bases, I would say.
Absolutely.
So let's go back to that lovely word that Joe likes, life hack. Okay, so we've seen in a previous video presentation me showing you how to add a thread to a conduit. We went in dry, and then we put some lubrication on, some cutting compound, as it would be called in an exam, in order to make that thread easier. However, we've got students from 16 to 60, I think, this year, and all kinds of physical attributes. And one or two of the learners have been sort of a little bit struggling there. And it's like, you think, oh, I could make it easier if I, you almost feel like, cheat. Yeah, life hack should be word cheat. But let's see what I mean by that by watching me from behind. The effort that I'm going to put in, Joe, in order to start this threading process. So just watch it, the effort that I'm going to put in on this one. So we've got it here. We've got our stocks and dies. We've already started a thread. And I'm going to start putting some more threads on it. So that's some effort. I'm obviously athletic in my early 20s, I'm at the prime of my life.
Yeah.
But this takes some effort, and I couldn't, for instance, I couldn't certainly do that with one let's get the guns out, like with one finger, okay? I couldn't do that.
And you've got to bear in mind as well, when you're doing this all day as well, you don't half feel it in your shoulders, your back, and your biceps. It really does take the strain on you.
So with the physical attributes of the learners being all different, okay, and that doesn't mean between gender, it's just generally the statement that we go with. We can make it easier. We know on-site, so people that generally chip in from on-site, we go, oh, everybody knows everyone. They do, but when you're 16 and you're straight from school, maybe there's a little way around it. Now, we don't necessarily advocate using it in the workshop for everyone, but one or two people that are struggling, we give them the option of...
Nice.
Another piece of conduit.
I don't know how this is going to work. Yeah, you sort of whack it around like that.
Absolutely, we're going to whack it around like that. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to extend out the arms, and I've seen on-site people tape these on, make it look like a propeller wheel, as they're just flicking it around, you know what I mean? But let's see, the big difference now is that when we use a little bit of science and principles here, really, don't we? We go further away from where we need to be, a bit like how they built the pyramids, wasn't it? Long pieces of wood, didn't want to flick those big stones into place. So we're going to slide that onto one. We can put it on both. I'm just going to show it on one just for ease. And I'm going to take one finger, and I'm now going to do that.
Wow, look at that. Look at that.
So effortless there. Yeah. So let's try again. I'll use the same finger, warming it up now. And okay.
Yep.
Nothing at all.
Hashtag life hack.
Along with putting your clothes in the wardrobe prevents them from maybe looking creased when wearing them.
Mind blown.
We like to call our one at home the floor drobe.
Floor drobe, yeah.
Yeah, okay, it's where we keep our clothes, right next to the wardrobe. Yeah. It's the floor drobe.
Super handy.
So that's the first of two life hacks.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was one to make it easier.
I like that. That's good.
Okay, yeah, just by extending these arms out. Okay, and our learners, one or two have used them this year. Okay, we're going to do the same process. We're going to reset ourselves now when we're looking at making it easier to put a bend in.
Absolutely. Okay then, Gary, so you've shown us that brilliant life hack, okay, on how to thread the conduit, making life a little bit easier for yourself.
Yeah.
So now we're going to talk about bending conduit. Now, this is an interesting one because obviously when you're bending 20 mil and when you've been doing this a while, it's not that difficult. No. It's not that hard, especially with the, you know, sometimes the quality of the conduit isn't what it was nowadays, but that's not too bad. But this piece of advice, sorry, it just hurts me to call it a life hack. This piece of advice that Gary's about to give us is actually, it's even more helpful when you're dealing with maybe 25 mil, maybe 32 mil. It really does get quite difficult at that stage.
The crying moment of 32.
Absolutely. Yeah. Hanging off the end of it, trying to pull it down. Yeah, okay. So, good stuff. So, talk us through this then, guys.
Yeah, so what it is again, you're right, we're only using 20 mil conduit. Often our lengths are 600 mil long when we're working with them in order to create most of the exercises we've developed here at Tresham College. But still, it goes back to, you know, people coming straight out of school maybe not have developed the frame they're going to live in for the rest of their life. And some of the learners come along and you can see them just hanging on it. And, you know, you go, oh, well, you know, maybe if you push here and then somebody else on the other end and pair of them until they get it going in order to start to bend.
Yeah.
So this year, the first year, I've actually sort of almost allowed the life hack to go. That's 18 years in. And this year I've gone, well, I'll help you out. Exactly the same as we did with the conduit. We just need to really extend this arm. The further we are away, obviously, the easier it's going to be to put in.
So you're increasing your mechanical advantage,
yes,
aren't you?
You've
got your certain amount of force. A greater distance gives you a higher level of turning motion.
So down we go there. Do you want to just make sure you stand on the bending machine so we can flip it out? So again, so we're at this end here. And again, you can just see how much easier that is.
Yeah,
because we're further away. So where the students are before, you know, putting some effort in to get it. Yeah. Okay, the minute you got that.
The good thing as well, you can carry on hoovering as well after you finish this as well.
Yeah. It's a bit of a bush fix. You know, it's what kit we've got flying around that we've got. Yeah, this was, you can't buy these anywhere.
No, I think a scaffolding pole is a typical one. I've seen conduit benders before, actually, that come with an extension bar, don't they, for the handle. They sort of sit in a little slot down there. They're obviously designed for that. But just one small word of caution with this. All I would say is that if you are bending big conduit and you're using the extension bar or something like that, just make sure that everything is rock solid, because I had a friend once who was doing this. He was pulling down on the bar and the bar gave or snapped, something gave, and he clocked himself quite badly on the head. So again, maybe try and always stand to one side of it so you don't injure yourself.
I'm sure he's not watching, but Cole Moritz volleyed his front two teeth out when we were 16. So he turned to us, okay, you know, we were there, we were supportive friends, and he pulled the bar and it slipped, and he just volleyed his front two teeth out, and he turned to us and grinned. It was difficult not to continue the laughter on for many months of his broken two front teeth. So again, just be careful when doing it.
I think I might have been vomiting rather than laughing at that point, but sure.
Yeah, Cole, I'd just like to say that story I've been using for the 18 years that I've been teaching. I haven't seen him since I was 17.
Of course, very tale of the missing front teeth.
Yeah, the volleyed out teeth. So yeah, joking aside, it's a bit more relaxed for us here for this video. Yeah. So we're classing it as making, you know, apprentices' life easier, a phrase that we use with electricians' life easier on eFIXX. So making apprentices' life easier by just maybe extending the arms out, and I would do both of them on the steel conduit.
Yeah, rather than just one side.
That was just to prove that you could use your finger. Yeah. And again, if you extend out, and you're quite right, the actual, if you've got a decent conduit bending machine, you'll have an extending bar in order to make it a little bit easier for yourself.
Good stuff.